Mountain is very famous for its rhubarb. I couldn't imagine Tamborine Mountain without the roadside stalls selling the rhubarb. So when people come up on weekends, they buy a bunch of rhubarb, and I'd like to think that they would use it straight away. So the best way to use it straight away is to have a recipe that uses their store cupboard ingredients. And one of the easiest things to do is to make a crumble. So with a crumble, it's really easy. It's just a cup of flour, a cup of rolled oats, a cup of raw sugar. I like to use raw sugar because it leaves a little bit of crunch and the caramelisation adds to the flavour. And for something a little bit different, I put in chopped macadamia nuts. And the reason I like chopped macadamias is because they're an Australian nut before they went to Hawaii and the Americans called them their own, but they are actually a native Australian and they're grown beautifully here on the mountain. It's a matter of putting those together, giving it a stir. And then I've got 80 grams of melted butter that goes into it as well. So it's quite a healthy recipe, this one, with that small amount of butter and the rolled oats for added fibre. And then when you make the crumble, there's no need to cook the rhubarb first, because last thing we want is soggy, sour, sloppy, wet rhubarb. So we've got rhubarb, and rhubarb always needs something else to go with it, and apples. Probably got an apple in your fridge at home. Core, then cut it fairly small. And then of course the rhubarb, which has just been picked. So, and quite often, you'll see in recipes, they tell you to string the rhubarb, but it's not necessary for tambourine rhubarb. I've never ever had a problem with strings in my rhubarb. So cut up in a fairly small. And it's not necessary to cook the rhubarb first because we want it to hold its shape. And then if you had some strawberries, strawberries go well with rhubarb as well. If you use strawberries, you don't need as much sugar, so I'm just going to put a couple of strawberries in as well, but it's not a necessity. You can put whatever combination of fruit you like, as long as it's got rhubarb in it. That'll do. And then, because we're not cooking it first, we'll put some ingredients in there so it makes its own sauce. So it's a matter of, a tablespoon of sugar, and then some corn flour, so it makes its own sauce in the container, in your cooking utensil. So it's a spoonful of corn flour. And then just get your little dish that you're going to be cooking it with, cooking it in. Excuse me. So this is the mixture of the rhubarb, the fruit, the other fruit, sugar, and some corn flour. So it's just a matter of putting that into your container, making sure you get mostly rhubarb, of course, and then you pack it down fairly well. Pack it down fairly well, and then we've got the crumble mixture here, which I'll just flatten out a little bit more, and then you can pile that up nice and high. And the other beauty about using macadamia nuts is that macadamia nuts don't go soggy when you cook them, they hold their shape. But of course, if you had almonds or walnuts, they work just as well too. So with your crumble, pile it up nice and high because it does sink. And then it's just a matter of putting it into an oven, about 170 degrees, you don't want it too hot, for probably 15 minutes, and you've got a beautiful dessert ready to go. All right, I think the crumble's ready. It's nice and golden brown, and I can smell it cooking. I can smell the rhubarb. I can smell the nice macadamia nuts on the top. So I just need to put this on a little plate with a doily on it, or a serviette. And of course, crumble goes well with a scoop of ice cream. This is a chef trick, just some icing sugar. Yep, nice scoop of ice cream, that'll sit on the top and it'll melt through it. And of course, for a little bit of garnish on the side, some sprigs of mint. So there we are, we've got the rhubarb and apple crumble with macadamia topping and ice cream ready to serve. I'm Terry Taylor from Tamborine Cooking School, and I hope to see you up the mountain soon buying rhubarb and using it to its best advantage in desserts.